bananas with a fat dick for your motherfucking mouth. Yeah. Just fucked off the monetization. Off the top. Raw and uncut. OG Pressure. Raw and uncut. What the fuck going on? Man. I need something to get in the mix with today, man. Huh? Y'all know what today is? Hold on. I didn't get my offering plate. Let me find me one. Let me find me a, find me something to big with today. Hold on. Oh, here we go. I'm panhandling. Don't get on here staring at me if you ain't got a penny or a 20. Today is Monday. Y'all know Tuesday. Y'all know the fuck going on. I'm panhandling. I'm out here trying to give me some goddamn me. I need some pennies in my pocket. Y'all know I do ask for money through the week. I need some money. Don't come on here staring at me and goddamn me and ain't gonna help me out. Who we got up in here? Everybody be looking, but don't nobody goddamn it. God damn, I know some motherfuckers on here got some money. God damn. Ching. Hold on. God damn. Ring the bell, niggas. Can somebody help? Hold on. Let me get the bank. Let me get the bank phone out. Let me get the bank phone right here so I know goddamn me. Y'all stay right there. Let me get the bank phone out. Man, what's happening, y'all? Y'all know what the fuck going on? I see y'all read the title, nigga. The FDA and the FBI. Niggas got bacon charges. Bacon. Niggas got bacon charges, y'all. Has anybody seen Diamond Stone TV? Some right there, Diamond Stone. The label right here, y'all know who this is? Diamond Stone. Have anybody seen Diamond Stone TV? Oh man, in fact, have y'all seen OG Percy? Anybody seen OG Percy on Diamond Stone TV? Have anybody seen that? You niggas playing with my clothes, nigga. I stay fresh to Jeff. I learned that I was shout to Slim Thug, man. Slim Thug gave a nigga some real advice. Slim Thug say, man, let me tell you what's going on. I mean, he say, you know, how he got all that money, how he stay rich, how he keep all that money like he got, man. How you save all that money like that? That nigga say, cause I stopped goddamn me buying shit, trying to please other people. Nigga stopped trying to buy name brand, all the name brand clothes in the world, showing up with a $10,000 pair of pants on, $100,000 ass. Man, god damn, for some clothes. And he said, I just go in there and put this on, make this look good too with the rest of it. He said, I ain't got to spend my money on no high dollar ass shit. He said, if I want to put on some high dollar shit, I just, you know, I get it, but just to try to pop it every day. Nigga said, that's how I save my money. And, but that's not even the reason we motherfucking here. I just gotta know if y'all telling the truth or not before I goddamn me start interrogating the witnesses. Have you ever seen a nigga be a witness? A nigga be a... Nah, hold on. Hold on, let me help y'all. There we go. Suspect. No. That ain't gonna work either. I'm gonna have to come up with a good one for this one. But I'm gonna wait. We got the FDA and the FBI in court right now. Y'all digging that OG Percy? Y'all check that out though. Tell me that hoe ain't clean. That bitch say OG Percy in the middle of that motherfucker. Y'all don't feel that? See that crib hat? That bitch say OG Percy in the motherfucking middle of it. Y'all don't see that crib hat at the end, nigga? See how my shit throwing the C at the end right there too? See how it's throwing? Y'all didn't catch that, did y'all? The P-E-R-C-Y. Y'all playing with my head. Don't worry about it. What's up, Mr. Brian? We got a blue tool in the house. Man, we got a blue tool in the house. Man, we're going to give y'all some definitions and some. I need 12 jewels in the house right quick. We need 12 by this one. We need 12 jewels on here, man. Yeah, we need 12 jewels on here right now. Goddamn me to I need some thumbs up to let me know who gonna goddamn me be on. You better, but watch, Bird, what's up, Bird? All right, Bird, I see you in the building. God damn me. Yeah. Man, appreciate you. Appreciate you. That's for you. That blue for you and your blue tool in your hand. Hello! Cherokee, okay. Lovely Cherry, what's up? Okay. She on post, god damn it. Got them twos on post. Okay, ooh, I see you. Say, but anyway, what a thumbs up. I need my jurors in here. Everybody gonna get in the juror. See in the juror box on this charge right here. But you gotta be careful before you jump in here. I need a thumbs up. Make sure I got 12 thumbs up. Goddamn me and 12 people, goddamn me, really wanna get in on this motherfucker. You better watch that, cause y'all see it said FDA and it says the FBI. Anytime one of them brought up, you might wanna not, you know, just be so quick to jump in the shit. Y'all gotta pay attention to this, y'all, because you know it's gonna be bars thrown all over the motherfucking table. You know, on all type of ways, you know, and some niggas might feel like, I'm talking about them. Well, if I step on your foot, nigga, yeah, ouch. I think I need my boy Ron B in the motherfucking bill. Where Ron B at? Anybody seen Mr. Bumbaran? Gotta watch my nigga Ron B. He'll pop up in the front yard, in the front of the house. Nigga drive way down here and be out in front of nigga house talking about nigga come outside. Ron B a fool with you, I swear. Ron B, you better quit coming up down that interstate like that, nigga. White folks done told you. Ron B is a real one, nigga. A real one, real one. Wise ass better sit down and be quiet some motherfucking world. Sit down, nigga. Enjoy family. Enjoy freedom. As you can see, they don't play. One of my tools, man. It's one of my partners that goddamn me got that tool in his hands. His name Ron B, man. Ron B is one of my monitors, man. Ron B kid popped up on me one day, man, you know. Him and his girl popped up. My mom was pulling up from church. Ron B and his girl pulled up at the same time my mom was pulling up from church. He introduced himself to me, man. I'm Ron B. We won't be talking to you. And yeah, I won't give you the address, man. Tell you, come on, Poppy. Ain't say gonna pop up for the Sunday service. Him and his girl came early that morning. They sit in on Sunday service right there. And when he left, he gave me $100. He donated me $100 to the Sunday service. You hear me? I said, Dad, he gave me. I said, Dad, nah. I said, nah, I don't do it. He said, nah, that's for you. He said, where your mom at? He said, I've been wanting to see your mom since I've been here. I said, yeah, nigga, don't send me because everybody see my mama coming through the door. And he had his wife. I said, yeah, come and meet the queen, man. He went there and took him to meet my mom. He gave my mama $100. I was like, God damn, nigga. I said, no, man, you just, okay. And then we were getting ready to leave, and he ran into old Tanya. And they gave Tanya $100. I said, God damn. All right, Ron. Right, Ron DMC, Ron, a bad boy. I said, okay, appreciate you, Ron. You made the Sunday good that day. Nigga, I like, damn. And me and Ron, you know, it wasn't about the money thing. It was about, he appreciated who the people that we was. He been wanting to see us people. Nigga said, man, I just left the casino. I said, damn. He said, yeah, I just came from the casino, man. I just left the casino, man. You know what I'm saying? Me and my wife did good down there. Yeah, we on our way back home. I said, damn. I said, okay. Run with his lying ass. Yeah, y'all probably just left the casino, but nigga, but that wasn't no goddamn casino money. Run come back about 3 weeks later. Just a little tell. No, I ain't telling on Run, because there's different ways you can dry snitch on niggas. But see, don't listen to me, because I want y'all to keep up with the charges that's on the roof, man, because we following a proper protocol here. I might throw y'all a couple of loops, might get bored a little bit, might get a little lazy, but if you keep up with the message, it's going to hit like a motherfucking hammer. Hello! Yeah, believe me. Watch what you're talking about, though. Well, time to bring old Mr. Whoop-ass out. A little order in the court today. Oh, I know y'all wanna know the moral of that story. The moral of that story was Ron B was coming by often all the time by then. Then one day I didn't hear from Ron B no more. I'm like, damn, what my nigga Ron? I call Ron, Ron no show. I call Ron, another no show. Something ain't right. I ain't calling from the show up. I'm just calling to see nigga you aight. You know, like one of my partners called me or just to check on me to see what's alright. Mr. Ron said he was alright, he just got out.
Nigga just got out for what?
What you mean you just got out? Nigga, you don't do nothing. You got a good old wife at the house. Y'all be going all the traveling, going up and down the house. He said, man, they caught the car.
Nigga, what was wrong? You was in a rental car?
Nah, he said my car was packed. So the car was the pack. Ron said, yeah, man, they pulled up, that motherfucker was reeking. They could smell the weed coming through. They tore the car apart. They found it. They ripped the fenders off. They cut this side off. The pounds was on this thing. Pound. They took this off and put it. See, yeah, it took the whole car apart. Yeah. Oh, that's why you got the Bluetooth on your motherfucking ankle, nigga. Y'all better pay attention to the rhymes. Hold on. Y'all better catch the balls in between the lines while I'm fishing. Now, I want y'all to pay attention. I'm going to say that again. You got to catch the balls in between the lines while I'm fishing. Yo, Ron say, goddamn me, the car was packed. They took the car apart, nigga. I've been gone. Goddamn me now. He walking around with that motherfucking Bluetooth on his goddamn ankle. Well, that lets you know everybody ain't the niggas that they seem to be. Oh, good old Ron got him a job now. Like I thought he had it first. But old Ron got him a job now. Working good, now he doing what he's supposed to do. Well, maybe because he got the navigation system on his fucking ankle. You niggas that come around with them things on your ankle, don't come around me. I don't care who you is, uncle, partner, so-called friend, preacher, pastor, because all you preachers got some too. You niggas just can't see, you got them suits on. You wear them long-ass goddamn church slacks, nigga. I see that motherfucker poking out on your goddamn ankle, Reverend Johnson. That's Sister Johnson, brother. That's Sister Johnson, husband, brother. Another one of the Johnsons in the Johnson family, just y'all, you know, in case y'all come to church, you know, Brother Johnson was at church this Sunday. Shout out to Brother Johnson, we seen him at church for the first time. Sister Johnson act like she had some sense. Shit, he needs to come to church every Sunday, keep her ass off the floor. We'll discuss that on Sundays, though. That's Sunday business. You got to know what we're talking about when we talk about Brother Johnson, Sister Johnson. But she got her husband's brother, that's Reverend Johnson. You know, and Reverend Johnson got an ankle monitor on. Reverend Johnson got a whole ankle monitor on his motherfucking foot. Now, okay. We're going to call it the FDA, Reverend Johnson. The FDA, Reverend Johnson, with ankle monitoring. Yeah. When you say the FDA, Reverend Johnson, with the ankle monitoring, that means the Reverend done something. He didn't have no motherfucking business, so the Reverend crooked somewhere down the line. It ain't something ain't right with old Reverend Johnson. What I mean by that, because you know, Reverend Johnson look clean, smell good, smell like deodorant and shit, nigga, smell like that motherfucking Old Spice. Looking ass. Yeah, nigga, Old Spice commercial ass smelling nigga. He come through there smelling like that Old Spice and goddamn it, but he got a hole. That means something about him ain't right. That means something about old Brother Johnson, Reverend Johnson, ain't right. They be the one dressed up in them suits and ties and shit that y'all think, goddamn, you got the good job, doing what they supposed to do, got their kids, got their family at the house. But it's something about that motherfucker that just ain't right. Now, what can Reverend Johnson... I know Reverend Johnson ain't got caught robbing no bank. I know Reverend Johnson ain't killed nobody because, you know, he got an ankle monitor on, you know. I know, but Reverend Johnson did some sneaky, dirty, low-down shit. We just don't know what it is. Until why? Some just come take it up, snatch the sheet off his bitch ass. Man, who the fuck behind this motherfucking curtain? Nigga, like I'm in the motherfucking Wizard of Oz. See this nigga over there working all type of machines and shit. Security and everything. Got all things secured over here, working all type of shit. You understand me? Nigga that snatched the motherfucking sheet. The little dog that ran over there and snatched the cover off of him and snatched the curtain down. And who we got? The FBI. I'll be damned. Soon as they snatched the sheet off this motherfucker, you look and say, "That is that the FBI? Yeah, that's the FBI, baby. How you know? Look right there. Right where? Right there. That's the FBI right there, because when you do that, that get that, and that'll get you that. Every time. Y'all remember that? That's how that. We're going to talk that there. Let's talk that there, y'all. That's going to be our new little thing on the station. Let's talk that there. That there, we talking about that. What's that? That. Right where? Right there. That right there. That's that there. That's that OG person who talk. Let's talk that there, huh? And on. And on. U-M-M. Yeah, that's how that, yeah. They saying whoa and yeah, man, all of you, we saying, and on, that. Y'all can't say that, like that. Now say it like that. Say it like that. Say it like that. Like that, yeah. You gotta say it like that, there. Yeah, like that, there. Like right there. Over there, right there, nigga. That. But anyway, back to the mission in hand. All time, goddamn, nigga. You better hurry up, nigga. I don't know all time. You better watch the door all time, please. Shit. Check the door, man. Make sure the motherfucking door locked. Can you do that for me? Dang, I was looking for you a while ago and you wasn't nowhere in the prison. Man, I started coming, send old Cherokee by your house. Or Bird by your house to go make sure you in there. Last nigga I checked, you know, wake your ass up, man. Get to work, huh? I mean, ain't nothing important going on, but we just need top-notch security today, Craig. We need top-notch security today. We need top-notch security, and I need you to open your ears and your eyes, and I need you to pay attention, because if you don't know how I talk, you'll never catch nothing over here. You're going to be sitting on the dock of the bay watching the time roll away. Hello! Boy, I know y'all be catching these balls, nigga. I know y'all catch the balls in between these lines while I'm out here fishing. I'm fishing, but when I'm fishing, I'm going to catch something. That's what you niggas don't know. While I'm on here fishing, I'm going to catch something. And on the real, niggas going to catch it. Bars. But I told you, I'm fired with this shit. Quit playing with me, and only the real niggas going to catch it. Man, Diddy. Okay. Y'all know what today is? It's Pole Pocket Percy Day. Can somebody help me out? Ching, ching. Can somebody send me a penny on 20? On $5? $10? $15? $20? Goddamn. Somebody help Pole Pocket Percy. Old Spice commercial. Look at that. Let's go, man. Goddamn. Man, shout out to my nigga CJ Casino. That bitch ass nigga. That rock. Say, my city fucked up down here, y'all. My city fucked up down here, man. Let's go. I'm gonna go to Austin right quick. Hold on. I'm finna go to this station right here. I got a nigga on the stand right now. I got a nigga on the stand right here right now, man. He on the stand. I got a nigga on the stand right here. I'm gonna let him do all the talking. I ain't gonna say shit. I'm gonna let him do all the talking. He get a right to defend himself.
That's one thing you do. You get a right to defend yourself over here. We feel like, you know, you're in court. We don't tell nothing on you. We let you tell it on your motherfuckers. That's what we do. Over in OG Percy Courthouse, we don't tell it on you. We let you tell it on yourself. That's the game. See, if I say something about you, that mean I'm talking about you, nigga. But if you saying it, nigga, that mean you talking about you, nigga. Is anybody catching it? Don't that sound much better? Let a nigga do all the talking and send y'all sitting here listening to me. Sit here and try to bash another nigga, take another nigga down, or, you know, put a nigga name out there bad and shit. No, you know, shit, don't let me be the one to do it. Let him be the one to do it. Ain't that right, DJ? You know what I'm saying? I ain't gonna be the one to do it. Let him do all the talking. Third Coast, what's happening? Let you niggas do all the talking, nigga. You understand me? I stopped playing, man. But anyway, we gonna get to that. Now I'm gonna have to milk. I don't gotta jump straight to the point. Cause some niggas gonna get the point. Cause some niggas don't get it. And to another nigga, point. Is that, yeah. Right there. What, right there? Is that him? That's him. Right there, nigga. Shout out to Austin, nigga. Shout out to my niggas in Austin. I got some real niggas out of Austin. And ain't that motherfucker on there. You bitch ass federal people, get off my goddamn thing, man. Let me play my video, man. These people got all my shit hacked up so bad, man. I can't even. Man, my shit ain't never been this waiting on them to get their shit from buffering. And for my shit play, man, my shit been playing like a champ, man. You know what I need to do? Do I need to change batteries or something? Maybe I just need to change it. Hold on. I got something for y'all, bitch ass. I tell you what. I got a brand new motherfucker right here. I ain't even put this bitch in motion yet. I got, you know what? This is going to stop all this old slow shit and all you niggas watching me. Because guess what? I mean, you got to come start all the way over. Bitch, you're not going to, you know what? I think I'm just going to open this hole up here and start from scratch on you bitches so y'all can get up out this computer. Y'all can have this motherfucker. I'm going to set this bitch down and sit up here where this one was at. Yeah, I think I'm going to go on, goddamn you. You know what? I got to charge them. I'm going to charge this old boy up and fire this old boy. Brand motherfucking new. Straight out the box. Get them, OG. Yeah. And that'll stop all this shit, whatever y'all got going on, this motherfucker, because it ain't the computer. I seen a bitch talking to me the other day, and the bitch say, my screen went blank in the middle like the hoe was watching something that I was doing. The bitch told me something one day that fucked me up. The bitch said, every time you go, you get on your Google, you start exactly where you left off. I asked the bitch, well, bitch, how you know that? Because only I know that. Bitch, I'm the only one on my photos doing shit. You know, you say every time you go back to your shit, you always start where you left off every time. And go right back to the same spot. Well, bitch, you wouldn't say nothing like that unless you being nosy in a motherfucker hole and you know some shit like that, bitch. That means, bitch, you been being nosy. Bitch, that means you got something, you know, a mind, bitch, that you shouldn't have. And then, bitch, I was talking to you and you said, damn, your picture just popped up. Well, when the bitch said that, it's a picture popped up on my screen, and bitch, I ain't even touched the goddamn screen to pop it up. She said, yeah, you looked at, and I'm looking at you, look at the picture on my shit, bitch. Gave yourself up. Your shit too goddamn incompatible with mine. And bitch, yeah, you do got all my information, ho, because I gave it to you. But you know what? Then you know you don't fuck with these hoes, and hoes just get curious, and hoes get nosy. Hoes get curious, and hoes get nosy, just like niggas. You got a lot of curious, nosy ass niggas. And what a nosy nigga do, ain't nothing worse than a nosy nigga. I swear to God, another nigga that's being mean, that's weak to me. I can't stand a nigga. I see hoes be nosy. They used to sit on the porch on my block back in the day, a family of them. And they just sit on the porch and be nosy. Bitch, you couldn't do steal shit. I be wanting to break into somebody's house on the street. I can't break into nobody's house on this street. You ain't gonna get away with it. You gonna get caught, nigga. You gonna get caught. Bad as I want to come steal something off this motherfucking block. I can't even rob niggas on, because we got some nosy motherfucking neighbors sitting on the porch that ain't gonna go in the house. Ain't gonna be in everything, bitch. Yeah. They can hear when your door closed down the street, somebody, they all look down the street. when they hear a front door close. Everybody look down the street, see who leaving. Somebody leaving down there? Damn, these hoes nosy. And guess what? They don't give a fuck that you know that they nosy, because they gonna do that till they die. And guess what? R.I.P. to the Freemans, man. R.I.P. to Miss Joyce. R.I.P. to May. R.I.P. to Lisa. R.I.P. to Bob. R.I.P. to Bill. That whole five porches, they gone now. R.I.P. to their brother Don Wayne, too. And Big Marcus. That's a whole family gone. But I watched that family sit on the porch every motherfucking day faithfully. I never understood when the white man kept calling us porch monkeys. What the fuck is a porch monkey? You bitch, that shit so weak. What the fuck is a porch monkey? Then I found out what a porch monkey, but I got old. You know, I didn't know what a porch monkey was for years. Bunch of monkeys sitting on the porch. That's what they said. Bunch of niggas sitting on the porch, just sitting there. Porch monkeys. I mean, and the sad thing about it didn't dawn on me until I got older. I'm like, oh, damn, white folks ain't shit. That crooked motherfucking hoe. That mean they had something in my face the whole time and it didn't dawn on me till I got older. Well, that's just how the feds work. Bars. Oh, y'all gonna keep up with the charges. I know I'm gonna go around the circle because some of you niggas need to be missed sometime. I gotta make the shit sound boring because you just don't jump in on a federal DA or the federal Bureau fire and alcohol, tobacco. Yeah, you just can't go in on a federal DA. It don't work that way. The federal DA don't mind calling bag up. The FDA, they don't mind calling, but that's the federal DA, nigga. And then you got the FBI. That's the Federal Bureau, man. And y'all out of there. When you start dealing with them two people right there, you in trouble. You in trouble. You dig what I'm saying? You niggas gonna have to learn to read in between the lines while I'm fishing. Because only the people that use this bait know what I'm fishing at. Some things ain't goddamn thing gotta be told. Because if I tell it, shit. I can't sell it. Can y'all give Paul Pocket Percy a penny or a 20? God damn, can somebody give me a dollar or something? God damn, y'all know I gotta work for food. Don't be sitting here staring at me, nigga. Put a quarter in the motherfucking jukebox if you want this motherfucker to play. Let's go. OG Percy, I need a penny or a 20. Somebody send me a penny or a 20. God damn. 344 people. I know everybody ain't broke on this motherfucker. Well, you know, but me, I'm the pole pocket nigga. I'm the nigga that ain't got shit in his pockets. God damn, I'm the one asking for it. Hold on, let me see what I got in this pocket. Shit, nothing. See what I got in this pocket. Shit, not a motherfucking thing. God damn, is anybody gonna help me? You just gonna stare at me doing bad. It ain't nobody gonna help. God damn, you niggas. Boy, niggas ain't. Boy, I swear to God, I love y'all though. Boy, nigga, that's how them niggas be going out when they be trying to get some money for real. No. Oh, man, niggas ain't shit, man. Nigga, ain't nobody gonna help a nigga, man. My family ain't shit. My family, that's all niggas say. Your family ain't shit, nigga, because every time you come around, you want something, and they don't want to give it to you. So now they ain't shit. Bars. Niggas. I know I'm wrong with this shit, y'all. That better keep up. It's goddamn me cakes, nigga. Nigga type of nigga say his family ain't shit because every time you come around, nigga, you want something. And when they don't give it to you, oh, now all of a sudden they ain't shit, man. My family ain't shit because you always want something, nigga. And when they don't give it to you, now they ain't shit. Yeah. Yeah. I know some niggas like that. Don't let me get on this goddamn me cocaine cake. That's what you call a cocaine bar. Yeah. Niggas think I'm racist because I always talk about white shit. Bars. Y'all feeling the balls, nigga? Anybody fuck with me on the balls today? Anybody fucking with me? Yeah, niggas think I'm racist because I'm always talking about white shit, nigga. That's how I like my pussy. White on the outside, pink in the middle. Look at that. Pink in the middle. White on the outside and pink in the middle. Ain't that a nice motherfucker, though? Yep. And when it comes to black pussy, I like my shit burnt on the outside and pink in the middle. Hello! Yeah. Yep. When it comes to eating the barbecue, I like my black women like the barbecue, nigga. I like it black on the outside and pink in the middle. Yes, sir. Straight up, nigga. I love the pink. Not the dry pink. No dry pink. I want no dry pink. No dry pink. Please, no dry pink. I don't like dry pink. Ugh. Can't get nothing out of no dry pink. Like trying to squeeze juice out of a brick. You can't get it. Man. Hold up, and then go back to your boy, okay? Most definitely. Hold on, let me see that Austin start me out real quick. Let's go, AT.
Mistaken for Houston. Appreciate the compliment, but homie, this is Austin. Central Texas residue. Right in between white blood when I home on the Spurs. New Dolphins, water bottles, crack vials, water curb, you get served. Texas relays, Austin's home to the track stars. Runberg, Rosewood, Austin's own track stars. Round here, you get snatched out that car. Be looking for that motherfucker somewhere else from off. We got Crips, we got Bloods, got hundred glass in my city too. Know it's about a zip code, we screaming out the last two. Digits that we holding up, just so everybody know. That's a H of rock and roll, simple and that's Bebo. We hooking the horns, I'm on that South by Southwest roster. Rest in peace, the key on the scuba, toting monster. The A ain't only in Atlanta, man. Out of time, let's bring a fan. What is this? Ain't no defeat. We on that bitch young shit. I'm out of Thomas Court trying to bone this bitch. Fuck off like you know.
Back to the mission at hand, niggas. I know it. I know it. I know it. Say y'all. Too many motherfuckers been talking. We can wipe these niggas' nose. Shout out to my niggas, man. I went on to the Sauce Walk platform. Y'all, if anybody haven't checked it out by now, I dropped a video on the Sauce Goddamn Me podcast. And I believe you know what we do over here, Cherokee. What we do over here, Loyalty. What we do over here, Bird. All time, what we do over here, man. Y'all know what the fuck Greg Abbott let me come home, nigga. Shit, y'all know what we do over here. You know, y'all on this motherfucker leave. Wherever he go, we go. My buddies. Bars. Yeah, I'm gonna y'all keep soaking that one for a minute. But I went on the Austin podcast, man. Peanut the Dumbs. Shout out to them boys over there, man. I went over and I blessed their game. Let me show y'all what happened. I asked him how much did it cost. He says $200 to do something on this mic. Well, here's $200. Yeah, it says $200 to do something over here, man. Yeah, Cherokee, you know, no doubt, Bird. No doubt, Cherokee. No doubt all time. Y'all know what the fuck we do over here, nigga. We watch out. You understand me? I try to treat my people just like I do Peanut. I only keep, you know, one male dog in the backyard and the rest females, you hear me? One peanut, the only goddamn male, you hear me? One male dog and the rest female, nigga, ain't no more, you know what I'm saying? Back to the mission at hand. Let's see if I waited long enough. 35 minutes. Let me see. If I made $35 right now, I might go and just goddamn me bring up our first witness and get this shit to rolling. Hold on. Let's say I got everything in hand. Hold on. Damn it, I might get the munchies. So I had to go get the mega size. That boy ain't shit easy. That nigga went and got the mega. It's a mega size box, you got. Damn right, nigga, it's a mega size. See how big this mother. This bitch big as a bag of dog food, nigga. That nigga went and got the mega size. Let's see what's so mega about this. What's the rest? Let's see what. We get into that shit in the middle. God damn, nigga, this nigga here ain't shit. Person ain't shit. Y'all don't play with me out here, nigga. Don't, hey, you see what my nigga do right there? Big spoon up. I be just like them nigga diving in that bowl of cereal. See how them nigga doing with that spoon? They sitting in the bowl of cereal. They don't be diving in that bowl of cereal like them niggas, man. Bitch. Yep, I'm gonna go dive in me a bowl of them Fruity Pebbles in a minute. You know, for all you Fruity Pebble people. But I went over to that station over there, man. I did a wonderful job, man. Shout out to them boys. I was walking by and I said $200 to get on the mic. I'm gonna change hats real quick, y'all. I need my hat on. I love that with these shit. That bitch still clean. It's got that black on blue too. Oh yeah, that bitch work. Yeah. No. That'll work for today. Goddamn. Why the nigga keep on rolling on? But anyway, I went over there and I did, you know, I'm a number type person. And I walking by and he said, it says $200 to get on the mic and do your thing. I said, damn, $200? I said, shit. I said, okay. Damn, man, that's $100 a minute. I got a 2-minute song. I got a 2-minute song, nigga, that's $100 a minute. Nah, you know what, that's all right. I ain't that desperate to rap on nobody's shit. I ain't that desperate, you know. I know I'm raw. When you know what you worth, you gotta know what you worth. When you know what you worth, you'll say, you know what I'm saying? I'm not gonna, you know, nah, hell nah, nigga. You know what I say to myself when I say shit like that? Nigga really supposed to be paying me. I'm not gonna pay to get a nigga paid. That's gonna be double jeopardy. I'm not gonna pay somebody to get them paid. Percy, how you know you gonna get them paid? Cause I know what I do. What I do, I do what God tell me to do. That's what I do. I can do anything else, but except what he tell me to do. But except what he tell me what I bet not do. And I bet not do it. And I don't do it. See, let me tell y'all something. When you obedient to the spirit, nigga, you can't lose. You got to be obedient to the spirit. All that old being obedient to yourself, that shit ain't going to get you nothing. But a bunch of drama in the motherfucking end. I don't want no drama. I don't entertain bullshit. That's number one. I'm a man, nigga. I'm a gangster. I'll be way on point besides what these other niggas be on. But I'm not gonna pay this man to get him paid. But you gotta say, person, how you know what you drop gonna get him paid, nigga? Cause I know me, nigga. I know when, you know, I do, when a God tell me to do something, I can go ahead and get gangster. Now you gonna pay $200 to do a gangster song. I bet not. But I will pay $200 to get a message out. Hello! How about that? I will pay that $200 to get a message out. But now I ain't got no $200 to pay like that. If I had $200 on, goddamn, man, shit, I wouldn't be goddamn me ringing the alarm. Poe Pocket Percy, y'all gotta hit me out. Goddamn, somebody give me a dollar, penny, or 20. Quit staring at the conversation, nigga. Somebody drop me some. That no, I ain't got nothing. I'm broke today, y'all. Cause somebody shoot me a penny or a 20 to my cash app at Percy 52 Demerson. Percy 52 Demerson. And if you want to send the 52, that's cool. I take the $52 too. Shit. Hell, I take 52 cents if you send it to me. I wouldn't give a damn, nigga. The cents add up. It'll be a dollar real soon. Don't that make sense? Shit, nigga. What the fuck you talking about? But anyway, I passed it up and I see that. I said, hey, man, I'm gonna go and walk off. I ain't balling like these niggas. I'm gonna give away no 200. I just gave away $100 and, you know, I just gave away $500. I gave each one of them poor people down there $100 a piece and told them to put it in their hand. Cause somebody, I asked one of them old dudes, I said, man, give me a dollar. If y'all go back and look at the video, I don't even think I dropped it. I didn't drop it. I didn't drop it. Damn. But I got it in my phone. I'm gonna drop it. I walked by and I asked the dude, I said, man, can I tell one of the white boys? I said, man, give me a dollar. They was sleeping on some sleeping bags. They had some sleeping bags and they had the little cup. One had two of them had quilts. The other two had some sleeping bags and they would lay stretched out. They was calling it a night. They was taking it in for the night right on the sidewalk. And I peeped gang. I said, man, why y'all let me have a dollar? Shit. And then the Mexican dude jumped up and he started digging in like he really finna help me out. He took his little change out. He said, I ain't got a dollar. I said, well, shit, why don't y'all give me a dollar? They knew if he didn't have a dollar, shit, they act like if he ain't got it, we sure ain't got it. A dollar? All right, that's cool. I said, here, shit, let me give y'all a dollar, here. I never let them see what it was before I gave it to him. I just took it and balled $100 up like this. And I stuck it in his hand, I took the other $100. I balled it up in my hand like this, and I put it in the other one hand. And I balled all of the money up, and I put it in the hand. I said, now don't open up your money until I leave. I said, don't open up your hand until I walk off. Don't open your hand. They said, okay. Don't try to open it up and see what it is or nothing until I walk off. And me and the officer, the police officer, I had a police, escort me to my car. He said, man, that was great. That was incredible, man. He said, that was incredible. That's what he said. I said, I appreciate you. It wasn't me, it was God. I wouldn't have gave him shit. I ain't gonna lie, nigga, I could have went and did something with that money. But when God told me to do something, I had to give it away. You know, old P-Dawg, mad motherfucker at God. You want old P-Dawg, mad motherfucker at old Percy. P-Dawg mad at Percy right now, he pissed off at Percy. He feel like Percy like that nigga that found that $1 million on American Gangster and turned it in. He said, man, you too honest, nigga. You turned in $1 million, nigga. Nigga, you just gave away $500, nigga. You ain't shit. Damn, I don't know what that True Testament fucking you up, nigga. You giving away all the money. That True Testament fucking you up on the inside. Is it? Shit, all I see is making me a better person. Old P-Dawg don't like that. That nigga trying to go get high. Not today, nigga. You gonna starve today, nigga. And tomorrow. And the next day. And the next day. Because guess what? I take it one day at a time and I make sure I wake up with the same mind frame. But they say you getting high now, nigga. This ain't what I'm talking about, motherfuckers. And you niggas act like y'all slow when I sit. That's all right. I'm gonna let you niggas just sit there and soak in that one for a minute. Why I get high, nigga? But anyway, I didn't want to pay the man to be a blessing. I told that man, I said, I got ready to walk. I said, OG person? I said, yeah. He said, man, no, man. He said, you don't got to pay nothing. Y'all keep up with the balls in between the line while I'm fishing. He said, nah, brother, you ain't got to pay nothing. He said, man, go on. He said, it'd be an honor. He said, it'd be an honor to let you do this on mine. Guess what I told that man? I said, yeah, because you're going to be paying me after I drop it. I'm going to do this for you. Now, I felt like the shoe was on the other foot. Now, I'm going to do this for you. And then you pay me later. How about that? I'm going to show you how God works. I'm sure how God works, y'all. How much time we got? We got an hour in, because we got another hour just to kill a body. We got a body. Ain't going to take long to dump this body off. Fat-ass motherfucker. Fat-ass heavy nigga been sitting in the goddamn trunk all week. We need to put his bitch ass, for go dump his ass off at the wrecking yard. I was going to go feed him to the hogs, but he spoiled meat. He spoiled meat by now. Yeah, I was going to go feed him to the hogs, but he didn't riding out on me. So we just called the folks to come get him. Let him cremate him. Family don't recognize him. He ain't number pork now. But anyway, I told that nigga, I said, you're going to be paying me. You're going to be paying me when I finish doing this. He's like, all right. I said, yeah, send me something when I finish this. I'm still waiting, nigga. Send me something. You know what? Because it's a little thing. Lil Wayne said a long time ago, he said, numbers don't lie. Men lie. Women lie, but numbers don't lie. Say that again with me. Men lie, women lie, but numbers never. Never. You can't lie about that's number one. Number two, three, and four, you can't lie. Numbers never lie. Damn shame. Ain't it, man? It's a damn shame. Numbers never lie, man. Up. But peep game out though. After I finished doing the video for him, man, I told him I did my little video for him, and I went back and I watched the numbers, and I said, oh man, these niggas ain't gonna do nothing. I said, well, I looked at the views. One guy got 233 views. Another guy, the highest viewed video on here is 1,500. Let's see what we got here. We got 203 views right there. That's the highest one so far. Well, 205 views. I mean, 1,005 views. Hold on, let's go back. Yeah, six. Okay, hold on, let's do this again. Let's try this again. Oh, we got 200. Let me show you how numbers don't lie. 206 days. Okay. 1.5K. 2 weeks. Okay. What's this? 600. Well, up. 164 views? What? That's 13 days ago? Hold on. Keep going. Let's see what we got here. Damn. 80 views. This on that Sauced Up Podcast. Sauced Up Podcast, I told y'all. Y'all got performances about some niggas. Y'all, they going in. Everybody dropping. Everybody popping. Niggas doing, I do numbers. I do numbers, Mr. Popping. Start over, Mr. Poppin'. Everybody poppin', he's the highest cold motherfucker on here. 1.5, goddamn me, shit. Then you got that boy Big Ziggy, nigga, goddamn. 13 days ago, Big Ziggy dropped. Hold on, bitch, y'all kidding me now. I just show y'all niggas the number. Big Ziggy dropped, okay, then that little boy, okay. 200, okay, 222 views. Goddamn me, 6 days ago, 86 views in 6 days. 200 and goddamn me, what views and goddamn, I mean, everybody was on this bitch blowing their shit. And then you went though, goddamn, you even have this goddamn person you jumped in the ring with all this. And then old Pole Pocket Percy jumped in there and it's been like 4 days ago. What you looking like, Percy? God damn. Me and numbers, shut up, nigga. Numbers don't lie, nigga. Numbers don't lie. Look, there it is right there, y'all. Motherfucking numbers don't lie, nigga. Look at that. Ooh, nigga, that's just goddamn me. What'd that say? 4 days ago. I do some order in the court now, man. And then on that mission right there, man, this is what we finna do right now. Now, real 37,000? Goddamn. When you gonna see me the check, nigga? bars. Did y'all catch on to that? Did y'all catch on to that? Did y'all catch up? I said 37,000, nigga. In what was that, three? How many days ago? Damn, y'all wanna hear it? Y'all wanna see the work? For y'all that didn't see the video, if you ain't tuned in to it yet right now. What? How much do I need? Nigga gonna send me something major. I know that's right. Right here, man. The video of OG Percy he dropped was called Pain, nigga. And it took me 2.6 seconds to drop that song right there. Made that for my brother AD. It's called You Can't Feel My Pain. Look at this, y'all. Oh, goddamn. That nigga, you did some numbers like that, person? That's just 4 days ago. That's 4 days ago. Man, that's 4 days ago. Pain, man. We gonna get, let me let the bitch reboot whenever the feds let me get some action. And let me shit play. It'll jump on. We get let it play. 37,000, y'all. How many comments on this boy? What the people saying about it? God damn, boy. 300 and said, wait a minute, what this nigga say over here? He said, the old guy, Percy, what? Better than 99% playing today, man. What? Damn. And I stand on that. Okay. Okay. Tell the flesh, say, okay. Nigga said, he stand on that. Man, he said, the old guy, Percy, is better than 99% of these niggas. Let's go. The message is in the song, y'all. I told y'all I do grown folk rap at its finest. I don't rap for young niggas. I rap for grown folks. So the young folks can feel it. The young folks can feel it. And the young folks can feel the rap. And the grown folks can jam the rap. One thing about some grown people, they still want to listen to rap, but they don't want to listen to that bullshit. They want to listen to some rap. They don't want to have to come take their good old Jay-Z out and put in some motherfucking you know, some goddamn me, some drill music. I'm a grown folk won't sit there and be riding around drilling. They want to put in something that they can listen to, and the young niggas be jamming it to. Yeah, mama, play that by Percy. Play that OG Percy. That boy, he jumped in there at 54 years old and popped it at the sidewalk and went in on this motherfucker. Walked across the street, look, you did good, boy. Get yourself a pat on the back. The city say the video gonna get shot, and I'm having a nice vision of the video.
Can't feel my pain.
Ooh.
Pain.
Huh?
Pain. Pain. Our money power changed us. Death is something that we never ever figure out. But we ain't gonna be satisfied. I was running out. My mama told me, death is just a part of life. The Bible told me, after the dark comes to light. I know my time coming. Huh. It ain't gonna lie. The longer I live, God, please, I don't wanna die. Huh. Cause everybody with their mean mugs and cold stares. If I did die tonight, my brother, who cares? I'm strong enough to face the madness, why I don't cry. Since a child, I've been addicted to the dark side. Look how dark it gets when you're on your last breath. My tombstone will read a G to his last breath.
Look how dark it gets when you're on your last breath. My tombstone will read a G to his last breath.
You can't feel my pain. 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 You can't feel my pain.
I knew a man in his heart that didn't believe in God. He met boy, it ain't no God, he was a gangster.
Huh.
He just did 10
and P.A.G.
I'ma tell half of the story, you feel the rest in. He got caught making a dope run without his gun. They took everything he brought, even his youngest son. You should have seen him, he was scared.
What happened?
A bullet wound to his chest, a bullet wound to his head.
Hold on.
You niggas talk that gangster shit until your ass dying. Have you ever looked in the eyes of a man dying? It's a sight to see when they on their last breath. My tombstone will read a G to his last breath.
Pain, 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 pain,
R.I.P.A.D.
Pain, you can't feel
pain.
Huh.
Pain.
Talk to him.
Pain.
Huh.
Yeah, pain.
Huh.
Pain.
Huh.
Pain.
Huh.
You can't feel my pain.
Nah, for real though. Real though. Real though.
You don't feel my pain.
Nah, for real though. For real though. That boy right there, so every time I listen to it, put a tear in my eye. I swear to God. That boy alive. Cause niggas don't. I'm gonna have my video shot of this, and I'm not gonna even gonna make a video. I'm gonna have my brother, when I walk to the crime scene and see my brother laying in that car shot up like he was and dead, still sitting in that car. Yeah. And I'm gonna have some highlights of the funeral, you know what I'm saying, on there. Cause he had an amazing funeral. Amazing funeral. I still got it on my YouTube channel. If y'all wanna go look at the homegoing of AD. Amazing from a good guy. You know, when you're a good guy, the church be packed like that. When you're a good guy, don't nobody come say respects to you. Won't see a pulpit full of ministers. You know, some people came to support my brother, but my brother put his own work in the streets and in the church house. And in God's house, my brother was a spiritual person. His home going showed that. The people that came to the home going, the sound of the home going, the feeling of the home going, said that this was a good man. This man got on to heaven. He didn't transition over to the other side. He good. He already told me he good. Yeah, he good. I asked him, would he come back? He said, I asked AD, would he come back down here? He said, nah. Mm-mm. He said, yeah, I ate. God damn. I said, okay. I'd rather hear that. Let me know shit. Just get ready, press, because you're going to have to come. You know, it don't matter how you get here, but you have to go through that to get here. I just don't hope I have to go through what AD went through to get there. Nah. But the sad thing about it, I don't want to have to suffer to get there either. But the sad thing about it, I'm gonna have to do one or the other. Either gonna get killed in these, you know, something gonna happen, I'm gonna have to get killed or I'm gonna die. Which one do you want? You wanna get killed or you wanna die? Which one? It depends on you. If you had a choice, please, let me see the status on that. If you had a choice to get killed or die, which one would it be? Which one would it be? No, I mean, I say killed, I mean, you know, car wreck. Car can fly off a bridge, tire blow out, nigga, you flip over something, nigga hit you with a bullet, bam, shot, quick one, gone, that fast, he didn't feel nothing, all you did was black out, boom, you know, hold on, let's see what we got going here, look like my phone was ringing, hold on, hello, oh shit, damn, that's crazy, my phone was ringing, but the motherfucker didn't ring, ain't that stupid? Yep, everybody plugged in. But at the same time, on. Numbers don't lie. Moving right along, y'all. You got 2 minutes, man. I got a very important guest coming to the stage right now. Matter of fact, I'm gonna call my first witness to the stand. Who do we got up first? We got the FBI. Which one y'all want to come first, the FBI or the FDA? We got the federal DA. We got the federal DA, and we got the federal bureau. Firearms and tobacco industry. Bacon. Y'all smell that? Did anybody smell that cooking? I smell bacon. I smell some motherfucking... Who could be frying bacon other than some fat, sloppy-ass pig? Cause that's what bacon is. The pig, they just sit there and eat all motherfucking day.
Free Whammy.
Free PMG.
Free Duop.
Free Little Percy. Free Pernell. Free Not Nizzle. Free Insane.
Free Go Bitch.
Free 4B, bitch. Let's go.
High
ain't signing unless it's for a millimeter. I'm worth a pound, walking through Interscope. Show up with his tenfold. Travis Scott, bitch, I got the antidote. These niggas fruits, cantaloupe. My little niggas dive, hardy bro. He made it like a snack, snotty nose. Cuz when we shit up your party, ho. Hey, I want to rest by the love song. We give up the smoke, a fuck ton. This nigga quit capping, you don't want none. These niggas just rap like they on some. He make it that nap on a suck song. He got me on the racks, ain't touch none. No speed talking, them shots won't buzz none. These little rap niggas my grandson. They lame, random, play that pack gone. Danny Fallon, bro, I got that sack, Santa. No cap, we clap, hammers. These niggas be tap dancers.
I ain't fucking cause she was below my standards. In public with iron, I ain't got no manners. I go down in that city, I ain't got no
manners. You know what? These niggas are rapping probation. We give it up, donation. They just be taking and taking. Complain, I'm patiently waiting.
Yeah, nigga,
you ain't a shooter, you graze him. You probably hit him and hate it.
Bitch, I hit her, she blazing.
She said her dick amazing.
OG, it's a nigga like Stacy. These niggas broke, they shopping at Macy's. I don't fuck with these niggas, I'm racist. I bring the drink out on different occasions.
Bitch, hey, you got me mistaken. Nigga, we taking it far as you wanna take it. It's four times.
I ain't that shit high. It's
four times. Free B4B, man. Free B4B. Shout out to Stunner, man.
Four way, you get shit to go
away, nigga.
Hottest in the pen, the young nigga alive, bitch.
The young hottest young nigga alive, man. Free PMG God, man. Free PMG God, man. Yeah. But anyway, came across some shocking evidence, came across my office this morning. We got an hour in. Yeah, we got an hour in. I know the next hour we will spend in court, you know, litigating and checking out what's going on the internet. Well, I got a call this morning from one of the district, you know, one of my assistants, you know, that partners up with me on this internet. Been partnering up with me for quite a minute. We didn't start as partners, but we ended as partners. That's how some relationships start with people. They start out kind of rocky, but they end up going a lot smooth. My partner gave me a call, man, and he gave me some shocking. You know, I didn't believe him. I can't believe certain everybody that I listen to. So what I have to do, you know, is do my side of investigating. That means I got to check both sides of the story. Well, it didn't take me long to check both sides of the story, because only a fool will listen to one nigga and don't listen to the other nigga. So I listened to my nigga that called me. But I let y'all listen to the other nigga. I don't talk on that side. Hello, boy. Damn, I'm glad I looked down there and seen my phone. Goddamn phone. Boy, you almost got cracked. It blended in right with the black table. I didn't even see it right there. I started, boy, you got lucky that time. Look at it, the police watching me. Look, I ain't even on no camera. Look at it. They got me on the camera. Look, my phone. Look, bitch, get up off my phone, bitch. How y'all leave my phone? Look at it. How you go on camera, bitch? You weren't even on, bitch. That's why I got 1,000 devices. I guess they all sit around and just watch what they can. That's what y'all call Homeland Security, y'all. That is called cybersecurity. They watch from all your cameras, all y'all phones. They got them 10 cameras on there. Only 2-3 cameras belong to you. Well, no, you got 2 cameras, bitch. You got the front camera. Yeah, you got the front and a back camera. That's what you got. And you got your Facebook camera. Them other 2 cameras, that ain't none of your goddamn business on your phone. You probably don't even see the motherfucker. You don't even pay them other cameras no business. They give you by phone with 19 cameras. You be like, God damn, I can do this, I can do this. Well, whatever you can do, they can do better. Yeah. They just watching you. Watch them. Bitch, you got the Bluetooth. Bars. But my partner said, man, something happened to him. I didn't believe him, man. My nigga said, you know, you gotta listen to the nigga. Nigga say, man, this nigga called the law, man. Nah, cuz, don't do cuz like that. Big homie don't do shit like that. Big homie square business. Big homie, you know, he didn't, you know. He's not a federal DA like that. Only federal DA agent would do some shit like that, nigga. Mm. only, you know, FDA can stand for Fred the Detective. Fred ain't no detective, man. Fred the Detective, FDA. Fred the Agent. Nigga said that's Fred the Agent. I don't know Fred the Agent. I don't know Agent Fred. What you mean Agent Fred? Agent Fred. Nigga said something about Agent Fred. I don't know Agent Fred. He said, yeah, nigga, he was on Ferguson with you. I didn't have no agents on Ferguson with me. Some niggas was calling me about the nigga, making phone calls. You know, I listened to one nigga, did some background check, you know, make sure my party just wasn't calling me, shooting me no shit, because when a nigga say some shit like that about another nigga, I feel like that's not just, man, I know ain't nobody gonna do no shit like that, cuz stand up nigga, man. That nigga from Ferguson, cuz. That nigga used to be Crip. Used to be Crip, so, or not a Crip. I mean, that ain't got shit to do with nothing about that go to do with another nigga character. I know a nigga ain't gonna do you like that niggas, and then they say, yeah, cuz. Man, well, I don't know, man. So I got the goddamn me tapping in, you know. Doing a little goddamn, I'm gonna sit this nigga ass over in the floor, man. Hold on. I gotta. I know that ain't you out here, but. As y'all see some of that background that they see on, y'all see all the time on your videos. That's that background they be looking at right there. First do all this interview, that's the background y'all get right there. But anyway, I said, let me hear this shit myself. See what's going on. So you telling me the FDA called them? Federal Bureau, call the police on a live. Hey, y'all ever seen somebody, yeah, cause you know, some niggas that's gonna do something to be snakes and rats, but they not gonna do it like that. I mean, you don't just endanger. Let me give the FDA, the federal DA a little pep talk. Let me get it done. Man, they trying to give me the... I really don't even talk about this guy, y'all. I don't even want to say his name or nothing, man. I don't know what y'all call him. I left the dude alone. I don't fool with the cat. I don't fool with him, man. You know what I mean? He got a good run on me on YouTube. Off a bunch of lies. He put a lot of Tony Rivers moves. A bunch of lies. A bunch of lies, man. But you know, that's what you people like. A bunch of lies. And a bunch of liars. Y'all like that. Y'all entertain the lying game. You understand me? Y'all entertain the lying game. Ooh, that's too much goddamn light. Dang. That's too much light. Nigga, put me in there. Hold on. Come on, cuz. Don't get to talking. Cuz I got a lot of shit to get back to. Hold on. Let me go back here right now. I gotta kill two birds with one stone. So. Nigga say, cuz. Damn, that bitch, that gonna blind me, y'all. I swear to God, is that better? Shit, that motherfucker, I don't like them lights. I'm a vampire. Light hurt my goddamn eyes. That motherfucker, that burning me up. But anyway, nigga said that the nigga goddamn me snitched on. I said, man, you just can't be saying niggas snitching on you, bro. Niggas calling the police, son. Don't nobody do no shit like that, nigga. You got it. And they said, no, cuz nigga called the police on me on live. I said, nigga, ain't nobody gonna call. Not a stand-up, nigga. Not a stand-up, nigga. Nigga, ain't nobody gonna do that. Nigga, you just drive. Now you making up shit on the nigga now, cuz. You know, I mean, I'm listening to my homie. Man, you know, he said, man, nigga, I'll let you hear it yourself. Well, nigga, that's what you're going to have to do. That's what you're going to have to do. If you think I'm going to sit here and believe you that a nigga called the police on the live on you just to make in, because I can't believe no shit like that.
Nigga on the phone with the police. Hey, man, he muted himself, so just chill. This nigga just freaked out.
Did he?
I just told y'all.
Damn, my nigga, that's crazy.
On the line?
Why are you fucking with that man, bro?
Listen. You arrested me. Somebody invites him.
I remember that voice.
He gave him my address, and I can show him the opposite when he get here of a guy in Seattle who posted my apartments on live. I posted my phone on the thumbnail to reveal what's going on with my kids. This guy been threatening me, this guy been threatening me for over 4 years now. Now I reported it to HPD. Yeah, I'm about to get
Yes. Alright. And is he black? What, Hispanic or Asian?
He's black. Have
you seen him yet today?
No, but as I've been online, when I walked the apartments, he said that he was in front of the shoulder office and where he said he was outside.
Oh, okay. And when did he take that?
He texted and like I can show, I don't know the time stamp, but I can show the officer in the car when he said he was outside.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so that
nigga said I posted his address, he just lied to the police. I ain't never posted shit.
July 13, 1973 or 1974
Okay. Do you know him? Like, who
is he? He's a person with a fact. I'm a YouTube influencer. He's been infatuated with me for 4 years.
Infatuated?
This is like the third place he did this to. I'm constantly calling the police because I'm afraid for my life and I'm afraid what I was going to do to him. But it seems like nobody's going to do anything. So I'm going to let him know how serious it is because it's not about me. It's about him thinking that he can play on my children.
But we got the bigger on video in his house.
Hold on, man. Go ahead, nigga.
He's in Seattle, but he's outside.
On his page right now, and he also has a picture of my apartment right now.
He has a picture of my apartment.
The police is
laughing.
All the officers now do is call me.
Okay. And what's your name?
My name is Frederick Abiola.
Frederick Abiola? FDA?
Abiola?
Yes, ma'am. ABIOLA.
Not FDA? Is that FDA? The big homie Al Ferguson? The big crib nigga Al Ferguson? That's FDA, you back on this?
He got them crusty ass toes on.
FDA?
The guy earlier today, he was doing a show, but he showed a DM of somebody who identified me from YouTube, and he said that he know where I'm at right now. So he was on a guy's show named He was on there, and that's when he divulged the information of.
Order in the court, man. Is y'all. That's the illest nigga in Nebraska? Fuck out of here. That sounded like Fred. That's FDA. FDA. Me, I don't. Listen. Hold on. Let me get y'all back over here and still. Man, that shit was fire. Boy, you niggas. Boy, say, hey. That was a couple of days ago. But like, that motherfucker's still fresh. Say, let me tell y'all something, man. Let me talk to both parties. Both sides of the record. To the one that called me on the record. And the one that's calling for the record. And they trying to get somebody to come pick him up. I said, the record, the nigga that's called, he calling the record. He trying to get somebody to go pick up the, he trying to get somebody picked up, bars. I know y'all caught them bars, man. I know that was fire. Oh.
Shout out to all my truck drivers going down that highway. Shout out to all my truck drivers going down that highway. Hope I can get y'all there in 2 hours, man. I try to get y'all there in 2 hours. Y'all know y'all can tune in to 2 hours with OG Percy anytime, man, and I'll get y'all where you're going, safe and sound. If you got 2 hours to get there, well, I'll be there with you for 2 hours. Shout out to all my truckers going down that highway. If you hear me, goddamn it, hoot that horn one time. One time for my truckers, man. Yeah. Oh, and shout out to my hillbillies. Shout out to my hillbillies, y'all. All the hillbillies that fuck with OG Percy. Oh, yeah, I got, man, I'm not prejudiced. I'm racist, nigga. It's a difference. Bars. But sometimes I'm racist, too. I don't like, I'm gonna tell you, I am a racist person. I ain't gonna lie. I gotta let you know, nigga. I'm prejudiced. Can I tell y'all? I gotta explain to it. Yeah, y'all can put this on your goddamn me thing. I know I'm gonna lose a lot of white friends for this. Shit, because I'm prejudiced. I'm gonna lose a lot of white friends for this. Hell, I might lose YouTube if they don't catch it. I ain't gonna lose just a lot of white friends. I'm gonna lose some black ones too. They say that don't make sense. Yeah, nigga, I'm prejudiced. Let me tell y'all something. I don't like nobody that don't like me. Bars. Hello! Well, I told you I'm fire. I be fucking you niggas up. Yeah, I don't like nobody that don't like me. If it's fuck me, it's fuck you too. Yeah. Whoever you is. It ain't no color on my prejudice. See, it ain't no color on my prejudice. Yeah. I don't come with a color. Yeah. I don't come with a color, nigga. I don't goddamn me Fruit Loop, nigga. I don't come with a color, nigga. If you don't like me, I don't like you either. Y'all see the look? I don't like you either. Bitch ass away from me, straight up. Just like that, straight up. Get away from me. Yeah. I don't like you either, bitch. Nigga. It don't matter. Bars. Hello! I know that's right. You gotta make it make sense. Like this shit that I'm hearing right here, this shit don't make sense. I'm in a whole different time zone than a lot of y'all. Let me show y'all something. Let me give y'all niggas some real game of OG Percy, man. If you sit down, you might learn something. Now, hold on. If you open your ears, nigga, and listen. Not hear me. I didn't say hear me, nigga. I said listen. Because, nigga, if you just sit there and hear me, you going to miss it. You going to miss it if you just trying to hear me, nigga. I just lost my brother 2 years ago. It's been 2 years now. My brother got killed. I went through some shit that it didn't matter to a lot of people. Y'all look at this shit. Let me show y'all what my screen's saying right now. Look at that. Somebody catch that. If playback doesn't... What? Nanny took it off. But it's too late because I caught it. Y'all catch that on my screen? I'm going to go back and look at this video and we're going to be able to catch that. It said right there on the screen, if playback doesn't play, check your device. Well, bitch, I'm not on a device. I'm on a fucking computer, ho. That's number one. And then when I showed it on there, the bitch flipped out. Yeah, I told y'all because somebody else somewhere's been choking. Yeah, I don't know how they doing it on weekend. He puts that nigga so nosy.
Say they use you. If they got the opportunity, they will use you. He even felt like Kanye was using him. Because if you remember when that song, Kanye was...
I be going through a lot of more shit to be fucking with a lot of bullshit. I be going through like real life experience. Let me tell y'all why people fuck with me. Because I'm believable. People listen to Percy because they believe what Percy say. Don't nobody want to sit around and listen to a soap opera. Don't nobody want to sit around and listen to some gossip. Nigga, don't nobody want to sit around and listen to lies, nigga. Nobody. You dig what I'm saying? they rather tune in to the truth because they know whatever he's saying, at least he ain't lying. OG Percy ain't never, ever, ever came on here and lied about shit. Or lied on nobody about nothing. Never. Never. My right hand to God. It's not a video you can play back and say OG Percy got caught in his lies. Nigga, that's after years of being on this motherfucker. It ain't nothing but, let me tell y'all, I watch a lot of, First 48 is one of my favorite movies. To make it make sense, because it's the truth. You can't practice getting killed. You can't pretend to get killed. Nigga, you either got killed or you didn't. You either dead or you ain't. You either telling the truth or you not. You either real or you fake. I look at real shit. People rather listen to real shit. You dig what I'm saying? And they know when I put this shit on here, it's gonna be some real shit. Even if it's, you know, it's not entertaining, but it's real. And it's real life experiences. My brother got murdered, nigga. I went down there to the crime scene. I ran down there because I couldn't believe they, you know. I caught on to the last minute. When I pulled up, they just said they had looked like the police got your brother jammed behind the club. I said, oh shit. I said, my big brother got drunk. He probably got drunk. Then let me tell y'all something. When I was on my way to the crime scene, I said my big brother probably got drunk last night because he was drinking. He fell asleep outside the club. They probably got the jam. Man, I was like, let's go get this nigga. They got AD jammed up. He might go to jail. Shit. And then we tried to run out there and go get him because I know if he sit there that long, he fell asleep in that car and got drunk. And he going to do that. He'll kick the seat back and he won't drive when he know he too fucked up. And it was his birthday last night, yo. He tore down. Nigga, we got down there. As soon as I pulled up to go pick him, I said, I seen the police on the side of the bed. I said, oh, yes, by four police cars. I see four police cars already. And then when I pulled around the corner, nigga, I seen yellow tape. I said, well, hold on, nigga. That's yellow tape, nigga. Wait, hold on, nigga. That's yellow tape. Wait a minute, Dave. Let's stop the guy. Hold on. I couldn't even... And the car hadn't even stopped. I down and fell out that motherfucker, broke my fucking ankle. I wasn't paying attention. I had like snapped. I kind of like lost it because I know what yellow tape mean. I didn't watch a lot of First 48. Real shit. I said real shit. I watched a lot of it then. I became part of it. Is anybody catching these balls in between the lines while I'm fishing? I'm showing you how shit get real from 0 to 100 real quick. I watched a lot of First 48, then I became a part of it. I used to watch the families run down there screaming and crying and looking at things. And I'm like, damn, they down there acting a fool. That's what I used to say. And then I became a part of the fools. Y'all see how serious it look right now? Yeah. Then I became a part of the fools. Yeah, I looked at so much of it, I became a part of it. I became a part of the ones falling on the ground, crying and screaming. I became a part of the motherfuckers saying, wake me up out this dream. Please wake me up out this dream. I swear to God, I put my head on the ground and I swear to God that I hope to God that I was dreaming. I kept trying to get out of it, and I couldn't get out of it. I was just trying to, please wake me. This shit is not a game, nigga. This shit is real life right now. That shit'll change your life, nigga. Right now.
A lot of niggas, don't be thinking that because you from Chicago, you
I've been going through some real life situations after that.
Panama takes your
grievance from Legacy. I know some people been going through some shit, but when you had to go down there, you know, I people ask me why you don't do this no more, why you don't do that no more. I hung around my brother.
for 50 some years. For 53 years, nigga. I hung around my brother for 53 years. For 52 years, nigga. I hung around him for 52 years. I took my brother.
Some things, man, that I can't explain right now. I can't talk about right now. But it was a lot of Chicago artists. I went to her house and
I listened to and I go through things. I go through real life things. Nigga, you can't feel my pain.
Places and
you can't feel this pain. When you run down there and see a nigga that you been around, I little shit out my big brother. That was my nigga. That was my nigga, man. That was my everyday nigga. Every day he got off work, sit on the porch, talk shit, man. We didn't sit here and got old. That's what big brother told me. Oh, goddamn, person, we didn't sit here and got old. We both got our 50s. And he said, well, you know you're old now. I said, I'm old, big brother. Yeah, you old. We talked, man, we had great conversations. Great time. Fishing. We catch out and go fishing like a motherfucker. Me, my little brother Dave, AD, and my daddy. I had just lost my daddy. I wasn't even fresh off my daddy's death. It take a long time to get over somebody that you love, death. I'm trying to go somewhere. You got to catch the balls in between these lines and pay attention, man. I said it takes a long time to get over somebody's death. I mean, they ain't got time to bullshit with you other niggas. Nah. I'm still dealing with myself. I wouldn't give another nigga none of my time. I sit here and just bullshit and cap, but as far as you getting some of my time, nigga, I know you not real. I know what real is. See, niggas can't talk real when they ain't been through real. Niggas can't talk about losing a loved one when you ain't lost a loved one. You just lost a partner, nigga, a friend, a homeboy. I said losing a loved one, nigga. It's a different nigga, hit different nigga. It feels different. It'll change you, nigga. It's your world. Another nigga wouldn't matter to me. I would've did anything to bring AD back. Anything to anybody besides fuck him and take a dick in the ass. He's just been dead. He just been dead. Ain't gonna let a nigga fuck me, and I ain't gonna let a nigga suck my dick or suck it. Nah, I ain't going out like that. He just been, I catch him on the other side. I'm sorry, AD. But I took out one of you niggas' life like it wasn't shit. You better ask about me, niggas. And come home and eat a sandwich to get my brother back. But then I had to realize, it don't matter what I do, I still can't get my brother back. Bars. I can't even get him no matter what I do. No matter how many niggas I slide, ain't gonna be nothing I can do to bring him back. Nothing. Nothing. And that's all I want. Just to bring him back. Nah, nigga, I gotta deal with that. Nah, nigga, I gotta deal with that. And for niggas that have been in situations like that, we never have to end up in situations like that. Yeah. Niggas that didn't deal with situations, niggas that didn't lost kids, lost loved ones, and brothers, sons, nieces, nephews. If you didn't lost somebody you love, you know not to give your heart to nobody else. Because you're going to lose that too.
I lost my big brother and I stopped doing a lot of shit. They say, why you don't battle rap? I took my big brother everywhere I motherfucking went, nigga. Everywhere I went. My big brother would have been living the days of his life right now if he was still here with me. And we got a book. We got a deal. You know, my big brother was a very quiet person, stayed to himself, didn't bother nobody. Very quiet person. He didn't bother nobody. The only person he fucked with is his brother Percy. Damn fool Percy. That's all he knows, me. And all I know is my big brother. We gonna go out and do something. We gonna have to do it together. Or my little brother going, you know, him and my brother, they on relationship with each other. We all was brothers, but we all did our thing. When I was out doing other things, they were still doing their thing. Brothers, you know what I'm saying? And then we all get together and be brothers. But we didn't lost ours. We lost a piece of the puzzle. In the worst way. You can't feel my pain. That's why, you know, I changed a lot of things. Conversation, shit that I do. When my brother got killed, I went through a stage where I didn't care about nobody. I would have fucked off one of these niggas. I'd have fucked off one of these niggas. Niggas knew not to say shit about my brother and about nothing in no type of way. I send them young niggas through there and clean that motherfucker out. Bitch, and they don't give a damn. They don't give a damn. They ain't talking about steal nothing, niggas. You hear me? I never abused my power on that level. I tried to save the ones that I know that was on that level. But nobody knew to play with me like that. But guess what, y'all? Let me give y'all some more game on top of that. This is the message. I can get killed off in these streets just like the next nigga could. When niggas killed my brother, nigga, I wasn't worried about the laws finding him. I wanted to find him. I found him. Oh, the laws know I did. But we gonna leave it at that. They found them too. The laws know they did. And we gonna leave it at that. Ain't nothing gotta be explained, talked about, none of that bullshit. That's all you get. That's the end of the book. The beginning of the book, that's the end of the book that you gonna get out of me. That's all I know is the beginning and the end. The Alpha and the Omega. But let me give y'all a little story about that. The shit I'm seeing right here, niggas calling laws and, you know, it wants something to keep going for. Let's go, man. I got a partner that went through that shit. This is what he said.
Chop right through Boulevard. Said,
you know, I got to deal with shit like, you know, real life shit. And niggas will fuck over you in real life. I've been getting, I don't really got nothing to say to nobody, but I got to just keep pushing because a lot of things are coming, a lot of things will go, y'all. Ain't nothing here forever. I never could figure out why me and Diamond Stone could remain the Kobe, you know, the Jordan and Pippen of the game. You know what I'm saying? We could have been goddamn the Kobe Bryant and Shaquille O'Neal. You understand me by now? Meaning that we took off. But you know, when you playing hoop with niggas, everybody ain't balling.
Who I've never met. That don't even make sense.
How you gonna beef with niggas that you never met? Hold on.
I don't just wake up mad and I don't know what the hell type that is. That shit sound like some such.
How niggas gonna beef with niggas that they don't even know?
Every inch of the world.
I'm listening to niggas saying niggas calling the police on them. And niggas like that, let me tell you niggas, so let me give y'all niggas some real nigga talk. This ain't trying to be funny or nothing. If a nigga calling the police, niggas don't call me. The niggas that he calling them on and the niggas that called them, please don't call me. You niggas is talking to the police. That's bacon shit. I mean, do that make sense? Because I'm going to feel like, goddamn, saw that shit going on, goddamn. If they listen to him talk to you and you calling me, they going to keep up with all the records. Who is he getting in contact? That's the type of shit that go on this internet. If a nigga call the police on you, don't call me. If a nigga calling the police, don't call me. If the police got something to do with anything and I smell bacon frying, niggas, don't call me.
I don't eat pork, niggas. Shit, I'm just trying to say, make it make sense. I mean, ain't nothing I can do if you call, but if you call, don't talk about the police. I don't give a fuck, because guess what? They listening over here like they listening over there. But the sad thing, niggas is calling them so they can listen. We just listen to some niggas listening to another nigga call the police on them. Am I making it make sense, y'all? Do I make it make sense? I mean, I'm gonna be a man all the way around the board. Because goddamn, if you don't play right, you get caught up with the FBI. Bars. I hope y'all caught that.
Yeah, bro.
That's crazy, big dog. Y'all know I ain't letting that bankroll.
Man, how do niggas become? How do niggas ruin their lives fucking with a bunch of niggas that they don't know? That's how niggas ruin their lives, when niggas have to ruin another nigga's life. This nigga just came, when this motherfucker said this nigga was been infatuated with him for 4 years. They been doing this shit for 4 years, and they been, you know, shit, sound like some bullshit, you know. Though he just told the police the nigga been infatuated with me for 4 years. I can't say the nigga lying. Because the nigga got too much information on the nigga. I won't even look up that much information on no nigga. I don't give a fuck where another nigga stay at, where the nigga drive, where the nigga address. And if I did know, I damn sure ain't gonna tell you and show you, nigga. Especially to a bitch nigga that you know gonna call the police. You don't do that. Cause why would you shouldn't, if you got everything, you study, fuck, that means somebody kicking somebody into somebody else. Ouch. See, that's what that sound like to me. Sound like somebody been kicking. Now the nigga screaming, oh, man, get him off of me. The nigga know, I mean, I wouldn't even give that nigga that much attention. I would have been to move on from that big, fat, gay-ass, pussy-ass nigga. That nigga, that a hoe. He been a hoe. I mean, we just seen that, goddamn. I mean, who the fuck entertain a hoe-ass nigga? Man, because y'all don't never hear me say nothing about it. I'm only talking about that today because the shit that he did is... It's crazy. Niggas are actually calling the laws on the lives now. You know, that's the only thing. I don't give a fuck about what he called them for. That ain't my business. Who he called them on, that ain't my business. I don't want nothing to do with the police on the phone. If a motherfucker called me, tell me, yeah, man, you know where I get now. Cuz, don't call me. I don't get nothing to tell over here. I don't crack my door for shit like that. I damn sure don't open it for nothing like that. I've been home 12 years, and guess what? I learned how to stay out of trouble, and that's not to go around trouble. And don't let trouble come around me. And anything got to do with the police, that's trouble coming around. Because that's what they here for. The trouble. It's easy to me, man. It's easy with me. It's easy. Once I say shit ain't going to get right, I'm not fucking with it. I bet not. It's easy with me. See how easy it is to stay home 12 motherfucking years and ain't been to jail for shit? How many niggas said for nothing? I don't got tickets. I don't got warrants. I ain't on probation. I ain't on parole. That's when you know you get it. And when nigga shit, this easy shit come around, it's easy. It's easy work for me. Because I know how to tell bullshit to stay from around me. Don't come around me with that. Cause like I said, if a nigga call the police on you, don't call me. The nigga that called the police, don't call me. Cause I don't want to talk about the police, niggas. That's trouble. Nah, I don't crack my door for shit like that. I live a real life. And the bullshit on this internet can get you fucked off in real life, niggas. You niggas don't pay attention. So when you niggas come around me playing patty cake, just know I don't play that shit, nigga. I play this right here on both motherfucking sides. You know, both. So I play this game by myself. I'm so cold, I can play myself. I can't let another nigga play me. Bars. Not saying that it was a play in motion. That goes on both sides of the fence. See, I'm off that shit. They on. I'm talking about.
What's up?
I'm on hold.
Then why you out there looking for 21? Man, Chop was stirring up so many.
I ain't been around I mean, I'm going through my own little, you know. See, I woke up yesterday morning and said to myself, I miss my kids. You know, shit like this. I said I miss my kids. I miss my kids, nigga. All of them. All the motherfuckers. I miss all my babies. All of them. You see how real life feels? Ain't none of them dead. Ain't none of them dead, but I just missed them. I wake up on shit like this. Damn, I miss my babies, man. I didn't find a way to talk to my kid. I'm put me a little, my own little piece of family reunion together. I'm do my own little burning in the backyard. Invite all my kids. Baby mamas, they can come too. You know what I'm saying? Put something together for the babies. You know what I'm saying? Even because they grown now. I got the grown bunch and I got the young bunch. Now, some ain't going to be attendance, but the ones that I can see, I want to see them. Shit, man, just put them in. Daddy fixing y'all something to eat. Daddy got something to eat for y'all this weekend. Y'all come up, pull up at the house, goddamn it. We're going to sit down and we're going to have a big dinner. So y'all invite your friends, your partner. Some good food for us. We'll sit around and get to see my kids. I'm tired of looking at everybody else motherfucking brats. Roach ass, disrespectful ass motherfucking kids. Motherfuckers that don't know how to say yes, ma'am, and no, ma'am. Thank you. Shit, man, that's all these motherfuckers got around these days. I know mine ain't like that. I like when some decent children come around that look like they on that gangster shit, still know how to say, yes, sir. Nigga, see your kids still say yes, sir, to you? They supposed to, nigga. I'm their daddy. See, it's when you ain't never been a daddy that you get the yeah and the no's. Yeah, no. You all right? Yeah, man. I'm all right, man. That's how you niggas kids talk. Mine? Yes, sir. No, sir, daddy. Yes, sir. I still get that out of all. Even my 34-year-old will tell you right now. Yes, sir, daddy. Y'all can see shit. I ain't going to call and put them on point. I don't got nothing to prove to none of y'all. That's gossip. I let you porch monkeys do that. Sit around and talk about each other. I don't fuck around. Y'all got me wanting a bowl of cereal. Hold on. Well, y'all running out of time. I'm getting them people down that highway. Loyalty, Bird, and y'all made sure them people made it down that highway yet? And y'all checked in on our truck drivers, Loyalty and Bird, all time. Shout out to my nigga Brian. I got the real Brian, goddamn me. Shout out to nigga Loco Vision, real bro. I thought I seen him in there a while ago with the tools in his hand early on the podcast. Okay. I don't do none of the reading. I let my monitors that do all that. Shout out to them, man. They the best monitors that you can ever have, man. They keep up with the business. Shout out to Cherokee Bird all times, man. You know what I'm saying? I don't put too much on my plate. I don't need a million. I don't put too much on my plate. Dig what I'm saying? Shout out to them, to the three amigos, the three stooges, the motherfucking three musketeers, the three heartbeats. And they say it's five of them. No, nigga, it's three. Nigga, that will make the heartbeat over here. My monitors, man, they do a perfect job. But anyway. That's my boy Chopper, man. Little Chopper, man. Young Chopper. Yeah. What you gonna say? You say Young Chopper?
You plotting right now how to take me, trying to take me out. I know it.
Yeah.
They plotting right now trying to take me out. Cause I'm telling.
Cause what Chopper? I miss that big Chop, man. I miss big Chop, man. Young Chop, I miss Young Chop, man. Cause Young Chop.
To the East.
What's wrong, Young Chop?
Because y'all ain't got no money. You feel me? Y'all get.
Talk about what's going
you
on.
You gonna take it regardless, you know?
Same thing happened to me right now, Young Chop.
I'll tell you, don't take that.
Don't take
don't
it.
Don't go do you. You feel me? They're plotting right now.
They say, don't take that shit, man. Go do you. Get your shit. I've been trying, man.
Yeah, man. I'm
trying to start out with. scratch. I'm gonna find me somebody that's white or Chinese or something like that that just wanna do right by somebody and get the business done. Yeah, let me find me somebody. They out there. I just gotta find them. Shit. Nigga coming off you $10,000 and tell you, man, woo. Yeah, Chop said, don't take this shit. They just be plotting on how to get out, man. I mean, shit, we done seen Diamond Stone run off with the whole bag and the channel.
Because
you know,
you ain't got
nothing.
I'm going to tell you, don't take that. Don't go do you. You feel me?
Young Chop.
They're plotting right now how to
take you out. Dude. You got
Take me, trying to take me out.
Yeah.
I know it. Plotting right now, trying to take me out, cause I'm telling the truth. They don't like the truth. Yeah, I'm saying that to say this. I just went through some things, man, that I can't explain right now. I can't talk about right now. But it was a lot of Chicago artists. I went to a house and came over there. I was stuck. And then Kanye don't make it no better. You feel me? He right along with. Use you, try to soak up everything, you know, get you the right songs for him, you know, and then don't call you after that, you know. Say for instance, like Don't Like and my boy Vic Mensa, like they gonna make it seem like he put them on. And he really f-ing did. Nick started from the bottom. You feel me? Them niggas don't like me. You wanna know why they don't like me? Cause I'm a f-ing boss. I do what the f I want. I don't brag them at all. I never did f them. I'm the king.
He was basically feeling like,
I don't dig ride these niggas at all. Fuck them. Nigga, I'm the king. Meaning, I don't fuck them. Niggas be sitting around, come around saying how they plot and get out on you, fuck over you, then don't even call you back. That's what they say. Yeah,
for Chicago art, over the years he was just out here making
that nigga, that nigga
doing what he loved. But
it's weird shit that'll ruin you on this motherfucker. It'll ruin you.
The world changed. 2020 will mark the start of this man's downfall. This will be when everything started to fall apart. Nearly 4 years ago from the day I'm recording this video, he got online with Gilly. They was gossiping like some little kids. I don't know what started the conversation, but I'm going to just let you hear it yourself.
The hard one. Who the scariest tough guy is?
This shit sound familiar, what niggas be doing all day.
The scariest tough guy.
The scariest tough guy.
Who be portraying like he a real street nigga. He's scariest.
21 Savage. The
scariest
tough guy. In my book, Enemigos.
Enemigos.
I like Lil Baby. He be beating my... Oh.
Why?
Because
he just put hands on you.
Who he put hands on? Offset? That he ain't, Offset ain't saying that. He Big GD, right?
Huh?
He ain't saying that. I'm a air it out, though. They was getting off the stage. I was coming on the stage. Matter of fact, I was going to the VIP section. The Nick Turk was there and everybody was there. AB, all them niggas was there. I'm going to the VIP section. Tell me I wasn't important enough to go back in the VIP section.
Who told you that?
The security.
So Lego security told you you wasn't important enough to come at VIP?
And tell me why I just recently at a homecoming out here. I had a big ass FN on me too.
And look, that little Instagram live started a war. It was Young Chop versus the industry. Everybody had something to say to Chop because he had something to say to everybody else. First, it was Meek Mill. He came to Twitter saying, it's obvious Chop having some mental issues. Y'all be gassing stuff too much, y'all gotta ignore it. I've been getting beats from him for years. I hope he get well. Then it was 21 Savage. They got the beef in and that was crazy. After 21 seen the clip, he was just on IG speaking his mind. He posted a pic of Chop and said, make sure y'all go get his tape when it drop, cause he need the clout and pray for him, cause he done lost his mind.
I'm gonna promote his album, man. Chop turned tweet. Wow, this sad, man. Chop posted a video and down Boulevard. You know, Boulevard like my second home. That's my hood too. Chop ride through Boulevard. He said, look pretty. I'm from Chirac. So, you know, I DM, like, bro, I be in Chicago, bro. A lot of me up there like, don't be thinking that because you from Chicago, you just the toughest nigga in America. Like, that.
Nigga, don't be thinking y'all come just because y'all from these other cities. that y'all the toughest niggas in America, right? But anyway, bro, that nigga right there, I don't even want to talk about that nigga, because I'm going to tell you something, homie. You know, I do a lot for the homie. When I got that phone call from a homie, and he said that this nigga need to go to court, God dang, I did my homework. And I'm going to do my homework. And I'm going to get this big bag of box of cereal right here, boy. I ain't even for the deal. This is a lot of goddamn cereal. I ain't going to lie. Y'all did the food with this Fruity Pebbles. Oh, Fruity Pebbles did the food. I ain't bullshitting. Y'all mad with me, nigga. I'll be on it. Goddamn me. Playing with me out here. Mm-hmm. I'm not going. Let me tell y'all something. I don't fuck with scary movies. Girl tried to take me to the movies, and I want to go to the movies. I told her I'd go with her, but I don't fuck around with that scary shit. I don't do that shit. Hell no. I know I've been to Six Flags one time in my life. Let me see something. Let's see what this lady got going. Let me see who I got here in the mix right now. If this is Mrs. Barbara D. Gaskin. Is you? Okay, we got it. How you doing, Miss Barbara? I'm gonna let you know right now before you start. I am on live right now, and there's 271 people on here, and I don't want to just bust out and go to talking to you. And
okay.
And have you on the spot. I don't try to play it on. How you doing? I read your message.
Okay, thank you. Been following you.
They're following you? Okay. I know they're the police and everybody. You hear me?
Yes. So we've been working with Sean Stevenson within the violence out of Ohio.
Okay.
And really just trying to bring together a movement. We have Melvin Farmer, we have Ayatollah Mars, we have Wavy from BMF, we have Sister Amina, who is Jed Fort's daughter.
Okay.
Bringing everyone together and trying to have a movement for us.
Okay. Who is us?
Us as a people.
Okay.
Us as a people.
Okay.
And what I say, at the end of the day, people of color, when it comes to the opiate epidemic, let's talk about that really quick. When it comes to the opiate epidemic, we see how that has, it's considered an epidemic now. But going back and calling it the crack epidemic in the 80s,
mm-hmm.
We as a people understand, how it was a detriment to us. We understand we lost fathers, we lost mothers, we lost a lot of family members to the crack epidemic.
Yes.
And so now this movement is really taking our streets back and just building upon, what we lost and really cleaning up our areas.
That's good.
And of course, giving us a voice, taking our men back, because, I like I said, I follow you. I follow several other influencers because I do prison reform and reentry. And it's very important to me to give you all, with that lived experience, a voice.
Right.
Because, we know how we were silenced.
Okay.
And, we're losing our kids, we're losing our people as of right now.
Right.
And you all have the power to be that voice for them and to clean up and to, of course, just bring our people, bring that, the knowledge back to our people, bring that lived experience back.
God damn, I'm glad you see that in me. Shit. Hey, you see something I didn't see? Yeah, she cut a light on this, y'all. She went in on me. I appreciate you. I thank you. Shit, I thank you for the faith, goddamn me, that you got. Well, it don't beat me. I tell people all the time, it's the God in me and what God tells me to say. I just work through him. I'm not a perfect person. You dig what I'm saying? I never even consider myself to be a role model. You understand me? But, I consider myself to be what God made created me to be. You dig what I'm saying? And whatever he tell me to do, I just be obedient. I don't got education. I don't got all of that. But I know God didn't leave me here for nothing. You dig what I'm saying? Not this long anyway. Shit, I couldn't have made it through that. And I would love to be a part of whatever you got going. It'll be an honor. You understand me? Just you know, to make another accomplishment in something. You dig what I'm saying? Because, like I said, I'm here to build, not destroy. You dig what I'm saying? Absolutely. And I was doing that exactly before we started talking. So tell my people how they can find you, if that's okay.
Absolutely. For most people, I did run for U.S. House in 2022.
Damn.
I am on Facebook, Barbara D. Gaskins. I'm on Twitter, at Barbara for NC.
Okay.
Email bdgaskins27889@gmail.com. Of course, I'm reachable, I'm touchable. Reach out, please. You know, as I said, this is a movement. I can't do it by myself. We're inviting everyone to come and help. And as you said, you know, it's the God in you and Malcolm X, you know, one of our great founders and fathers, did not have the education that you know, people or society says, but that was a great man, and you know, we can learn Damn. And grow from that lived experience. Nobody understands that lived experience just has so much power to heal and build.
That's fire, man. You sound like a strong, intelligent black woman, a Nubian queen on top of that. And it's a nice look on you. You're a beautiful woman. You keep doing what you're doing. Whenever you need me, give me a call and I won't be on. Everybody won't be in our business, and I'll be able to talk to you, ma'am. I appreciate you. And you can
Absolutely
hit me back.
Appreciate you.
Yes, ma'am. Well, let's go, y'all. You dig what I'm saying? That's the type of stuff I like to hear during the day. That would encourage me. That let me know that God is doing what he's supposed to be doing in me. You dig what I'm saying? I don't... That's the type of stuff I want to hear when you call me. I mean, do that make sense? Yeah, did you check out? I know all the time. You checked out, didn't you? Yeah, she's beautiful. Yeah, she's beautiful. She's beautiful, she's fine, and she's on top of her stuff. Can y'all tell the difference? Ain't nobody on her calling the police. Don't call me like that. Do anybody want to jump in this bowl of cereal with me? Better be able to swim, because it's deep, nigga. It's deep. See? It's a difference between them calls and the other type. That other stuff, see how easy that was to sit there and be messed up about it? And then you get back. Then you got people like this on your line inboxing you, you know, trying to get a hold of you to be a part of something that's going to help me grow as a person. And for people like Miss Barbara to be on here looking at me, that's a good thing. You say she ran for house. See, them other... Them the type of calls I'll be wanting to hear right there. I don't want to be caught up in all that old PNA call the police on nigga, man. Listen to this nigga snitching over. Hey. Going on with all that. Shit. Them niggas stay in the streets with that. Especially my nigga, he way bigger than that. Fuck them niggas, man. Them niggas be the last goddamn thing I'll be entertaining, talking about anything. If you call the police, bitch, the game is over. We not playing no more. I don't got nothing to say to you, nigga. You're a rat. I ain't gonna tell nobody on you. Nigga, I'm gonna leave you alone. How that sound? I gave everybody 2 hours. Oh, you got 1 minute to get it right. Y'all better talk to me. Who gonna say something? I hope y'all enjoyed the show today, man. I hope y'all enjoyed it. If y'all can help Poe Pocket Percy, I don't got a penny or a 20. Whatever y'all give me, I'm finna go get me some cigarettes. That nigga look crazy, ain't he? I got that black card. I got that black card though. The nigga say, nigga, that ain't no black card. This is a black card. Nigga, what y'all saying? Nigga, this is a black card. I got that black card. That nigga say, nigga, that's a Cash App card. Nigga, it's my black card, nigga. What you talking about, nigga? I got my black card, nigga. Back to work! Okay. Unapologetically say Shay. Who is Shay Shay? I need one of my people to look up unapologetically Shay Shay. Okay. Yeah. Okay, so why can't, okay, hold on. Okay. Okay, man, let me tell you hoes that be in my inbox, cause I don't fuck with hoes. Hey, straight up, I don't need no pussy. No money, only damn by no motherfucking pussy. Bitch, what my pussy gonna do for me? Bitch, if I fuck you, I'll be doing you a favor. Bitch, my dick good. See, you the one gonna get that, what I'ma get. You gonna get the nut, I'm gonna get a nut. Now I'm just gonna, you getting fucked, I'm trying to get fucked too. By you, bitch. Yeah, bitch, get on top, ride like the motherfucking rodeo, bitch. Get on top and ride, ho. That's what I like, bitch. Get on that. Fuck the shit out of me. How about this? Come on, perverted person. Make that bitch get up there, gotta get on, bitch. Sit on this dick and don't get off of it. No, come back down. They be trying to get out there. They go there. Oh, let me get out. They be trying to go, Cause once you get down there on it, bitch, don't get out. Stay down there and fuck, goddamn me. Work your little old pussy to death. Bitch be trying to jump off the dick. They be trying to get out that motherfucker. I swear they be trying to get out there. Man, they be, I ain't trying to get out. I'm trying to get up. Nah, bitch, I know it, bitch. It's a long way up, ain't it, bitch? How you get down there? You shouldn't have went down there. Now you trying to get up. I'm strong too. Every time you jump up, I'm gonna pound your ass back down on that hoe. Bitch, to my balls with it, bitch. See, I got pussy juice running down my ass. You hear me? Yo. That nigga, that ain't shit either.
I'm drunk, bro. I drink, nigga.
I got some bass. Somebody passing by. Cause niggas know not to pull up at my house. Basin. Get the dog shit slapped out of you. You don't pull over a basin. I hope everybody enjoyed the message today. I hope everybody got the message. I hope somebody got it. I hope somebody got it. Anybody get the message? Diddy party. I don't have no Diddy parties. Yep. I had them bitches jumping around. I had titty parties. I don't have Diddy parties. I had titty parties. You ever had a titty party? Yeah. Ain't number titties. Bitch, you can't get in here unless you got titties. Little titties, big titties. But just, please, just don't come with them old sagging, sandbag-ass titties. No. With the little raisin on the end. Added photo, man. Bitch, I ain't added shit, ho. But I added a photo. Bitch, I ain't added no goddamn photo to nothing, ho. Diddy still flying high.
Damn. It might be. That nigga Diddy got a couple of black cards. I know that nigga losing endorsements. Uh-oh. And white folks sent up in them big old cars, big old houses. They sent up there looking at that nigga, man. Hold on. Never take from who don't have, man. If somebody can tell me who this is rapping, I'm gone, y'all.
Man, I get a fan way. Told on the Charlotte Road. Run for that bus to Atlanta. Ain't nobody give a neck. Grind hard as you start, nigga. I'll be punching 13. You just start stealing car, nigga. You start stretching on your raw, nigga. Crushing bars in the car, nigga. That's what we had going on. Now I laugh with a jaw, nigga. Every string will get lower, nigga. Every skin will get gone, nigga. Keep it on your fucking face. Every skin will get hard, nigga. I have room to start the barbecue. Turn on that pocket, get shot off. You don't gotta take something down. Floor, how you got up? Send that from over there. Can't fold, it's a dirty game. All right, there with no folk that whoop the little Woody name. Come play, we finesse. Lot of time, we're the order one. Scratch for it, go blow it. Got my eyes on another one. Popped up a nigga earlier. I had to grow in these trenches. Labor skill, I'm out of me. See how I show in the trenches. Mind your business, get your paper. Keep it low in these trenches. Keep it on you, go finesse. That's what I know from these trenches.
You may have challenges that look bigger, stronger. In the natural, you don't have a chance. Don't be intimidated. The forces that are for you.
Hold on, y'all, hold on.
The forces that are against you.
I'm gone.